Hi all, myself D. Srinivas, working as Assistant Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, K.G. Reddy College of Engineering and Technology. In our today's lecture, we are going to discuss about representation of sine wave. Now, what is a sine wave? So, many a times, we use it to call any alternating current, we will take the reference as sine wave. So the sinusoidal waveform, that is sine wave, is a fundamental of alternating current and alternating voltage waveform. So in electrical engineering, the main two quantities we have, one is voltage and one is current. So for the voltage as well as the current, if it is a alternating one, always we will take this sine wave as a fundamental wave. Now if you see this diagram, here we are starting from the zero, and this is the shape of the sine wave. It is has a positive maximum and it is also having the negative maximum. So either it can be a voltage or current. When above the zero value, we will consider this as a positive value, and below the zero value, we'll take it as a negative value. So when this waveform has maximum value, then this is called as a positive maximum. If you observe this waveform, here we have a negative maximum. So in the y-axis, we will take voltage or current. In the x-axis, we will take it as a time. So this is the basic fundamental alternating current and voltage waveform of any representation. This is a simple representation of sine wave. Now, an electrical sine wave are named from the mathematical function with the same shape. So this is the shape of our sine wave. Now, the sine waves are characterized by the amplitude and period. So it is having amplitude as well as a time period. Just now in our previous slide, we have seen that in the y-axis we have taken voltage or current, in the x-axis we have taken as a time. So the time will represent the period, and this y-axis, either it can be a voltage or it can be a current, that will represent the magnitude. So the amplitude is the maximum value of a voltage or current. So the period is the time interval for one complete cycle. That is nothing but, here if you take the amplitude, it will start from the zero, it will reaches to the maximum value, again it reaches to the zero, again it will reaches to the negative maximum, again it will reaches to the zero. That is nothing but, we are starting from the zero and reaching to the maximum, positive and zero, and to the negative maximum and again zero. So from zero to zero, it is reaching positive maximum, negative maximum, again zero. This is called one complete cycle. So the time taken for that one complete cycle, we are calling it as a time period. Now in this example, so if you observe here, the amplitude of our example wave, here maximum voltage is 20 volts. So we can conclude that the amplitude of the particular sine wave is 20 volts. Now the time period is, here we have taken total 50 microseconds, then the time period is 50 microseconds. MS will indicate microseconds. Here if you observe, time we have taken in microseconds. This is the amplitude is, for this example, amplitude is 20 volts and the time period is 50 microseconds. Now the period of a sine wave can be measured between any two corresponding points on the waveform. Now here, so this is positive maximum, negative maximum, again reaches to zero. the consecutive points where it is repeating the same waveform will consider the total as one time period. So here, if you observe here, we are taking any two corresponding points that will take it as a one time period. So if you observe here, by contrast, the amplitude of the sine wave is only measured from the center of the maximum point. Okay, so this is how we can take amplitude as well as our time period. Now here the next one is frequency. So before going to know about the frequency, just remind yourself what is the sine wave and what is the time period and what is the amplitude. Just now we have discussed in our previous slides. Just remind those two points, amplitude as well as time period, mostly because of time period. Why? Because without time period we can't able to study about the frequency. So I'll give just 30 seconds of time, just to quickly remind what is the time period and how to calculate the time period. Yes, now the frequency f is the number of cycles that a sine wave completes 1 second. That is nothing but how many number of cycles will complete in 1 second, then that is we are calling it as a frequency. So usually frequency is measured in hertz, so it is represented in hz as a symbol, but is the units of the frequency are hertz. If 3 cycles of a wave occur in 1 second, then we can conclude that the frequency is 3 hertz. That is nothing but in 1 second, if it is complete 3 cycles, then we can say that the frequency of that particular sine wave is 3 hertz. So normally we will take our general frequency as 50 seconds. That is nothing but in a second, one sine wave, what is the voltage or current usually we use in practical, that is 50 hertz is nothing but it is doing 50 cycles in 1 second. So that is the definition of frequency. So frequency is nothing but frequency is the number of cycles that a sine wave completes in 1 second. Now the relationship between time period and frequency. So the period and frequency are reciprocals of each other. So f is equals to 1 by t and t is equals to 1 by f. Thus, if you know one, you can easily find out other. That is nothing but if we know about the time period, we can easily calculate the frequency, or else if you know the frequency, we can easily calculate the time period. That is nothing but time period and frequency both are reciprocal to each other. So the 1 by x key on your calculator is handy by converting between f and t. If the period is 50 microseconds, then our frequency is 0.02 megahertz or it is equals to 20 kilohertz. Now generation of a sine wave. The sinusoidal voltages are produced by AC generators and electronic oscillators. So as usual, when a conductor rotates in a constant magnetic field, a sinusoidal wave is generated. So this is nothing but our Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Whenever a conductor cuts or rotates in a magnetic field, there will induced an EMF. The shape of the EMF here we are considering as a one sine wave. So what is the definition? When a conductor rotates in a constant magnetic field, a sinusoidal wave is generated. So here we have created a constant magnetic field in between north pole and south pole. These are the flux lines, and here A, B, C, D are the motion of the conductor, which is rotating in a clockwise direction. So when the conductor is moving parallel with the lines of flux, there will not be any voltage induced in that one. So when the conductor cuts the flux, then only we will get the induced EMF in that particular conductor. Now here we are starting from the B. A, whenever it is parallel with the A, whenever it is parallel with the A, there will not be any induced EMF. So here the voltage is zero. Now let us move to point B. So here the conductor is perpendicular to the flux lines, then here we are getting the maximum amplitude. Now we will move to point C. Here again it is parallel with the flux lines and the induced EMF is zero. Now we will move to the point D. Here also it is perpendicular to the flux lines, then the induced EMF is maximum. Then again it reaches to the point A, so it reaches to the zero. So this is how we are starting from the A. When A is there, there will be a zero induced EMF. When it is reaches to the B, we will get the positive maximum. When again it reaches to the C, we will get the zero. Sorry, when we will get the C, we will get the zero. Again, when we will get the D, we will get the negative maximum. Again, it reaches to the zero. This is how we can able to generate one sinusoidal voltage. Now, sine wave voltage and current values. So, how can we define some definitions? There are several ways to specify the voltage of a sinusoidal voltage waveform. The amplitude of the sine wave is also called as a peak value, abbreviated as VP for a voltage waveform. So the maximum amplitude is also called as a peak value. It is abbreviated as VP. Now in our example here, the peak value is 20 volts. It is represented as by VP. Now the voltage of a sine wave can also be specified either peak to peak or the RMS. So the peak to peak value is twice the peak value. The RMS value is 0.707 times the peak value. There is nothing but if we consider only positive half or else in the negative maximum, then that is called as a peak voltage. If we consider negative maximum to positive maximum, that is nothing but negative peak to positive peak, then we can call that voltage as peak to peak voltage. So if you observe, this peak to peak voltage is double the peak voltage. Now in our example, the peak to peak voltage is 20 volts. The peak to peak voltage is 40 volts. We can easily say that this peak to peak voltage is double the peak voltage. Now the RMS voltage is 14.7 volts for this particular waveform. Now we can discuss about sine wave equation. Instantaneous values of a wave are shown as small v or small I. The equation for the instantaneous voltage v of a sine wave is v is equals to vp sine theta, where vp will represent the peak voltage and theta is angle in radians or degrees. So at any instant, if we take the magnitude of that particular sine wave, then we can say that is the value of that sine wave at that particular instant. Okay, what is the instantaneous equation of sine wave? V equal to Vp sine theta. Now if you take an example, if the peak voltage is 25 volts, the instantaneous voltage at 50 degrees is 19.2 volts. How we got this 19.2 volts? The peak voltage is 25. Here Vp is 25 into the instantaneous angle is 50 degrees. That is nothing but 25 into sine 50 degrees, if we calculate, then we will get the instantaneous voltage of that particular wave is as 19.2. Okay, this is how we can able to calculate the instantaneous value. So if you review our quick review of our today's lecture, we have gone through the fundamental basic sine wave, as well as what is the frequency and what is the time period and what is the amplitude, the relationship between the time period and the frequency, and what is the peak voltage and what is the peak to peak values, as well as equation of instantaneous voltage. Okay, thank you.